Hey guys, what's up? It's Bobby with Gilk Sports Cards. Hope you're having a fantastic day. Got another PSA blind sports card reveal for you today. As you can see, I unboxed all of my cards, organized it, but I have not looked at any grades except one. So it was a June special, about $15 per card. Got here in 6 weeks. So PSA was running at about a month, but they're definitely getting busier, and it's delayed a little bit. So it's about 6 weeks now for most cards. Still good, and got some good ones in here, guys. But I will tell you that I am very nervous. My friend Alvin and Ron got some cards in this submission as well. I've already delivered those cards to them, so I wasn't able to show you. But Alvin only got 6 PSA 10s, I believe, out of 20 cards. A couple of those were Pokemon cards. A few of his football cards were definitely off-centered, but to only get 6 out of 20 is pretty tough. And Ron got 1 PSA 10 out of 3. So it looks like we got a tough grader. We were upcharged one card, but again, it was for my friend Alvin. He had a Victor Wembanyama Purple Flash Select out of 199. I was upcharged for that card, but I wasn't upcharged for anything else, guys. And I have some cards for sure that would be valued over $500 if they hit a 10. So in my head, in my body, in my mind, everywhere around me, I'm feeling like I'm probably not gonna get a PSA 10 for my last two cards that I'm obviously hoping for. So we'll deal with it. They looked pretty good. I might crack them and resend them, gamble that way, but we'll see. So first, let's tell you the one card that I did check out, and this is my son Johnny's card. It's a fun one for me. I can't wait for him to get home and see it because we argued about it. He pulled an awesome Tiger select, which is a super short print of Pau Banchero, and he wanted to sell it raw. He could have gotten like $175 to $200 raw. They were still in the playoffs and playing pretty well, so there was a little bit of buzz about him. But like they got kicked out of the playoffs like 2 or 3 days after he pulled it, so we would have had to sell it pretty quickly in order to get that, you know, that hype machine. But I persuaded him to send it in for grading. It looked really, really good. Second year Pau, I said, you know, he's gonna can have some buzz next year. So he listened to me and he pulled the 10. So it's a beautiful card. So little Pau Tiger Select. I think it's his second year. So that's a beauty. It just looked perfect. So I'm happy. I was really stressed about this one. So I'm happy Johnny got the 10 there. I gotta think that would probably not. I was gonna say, is that a $500 card? Probably not. It's probably more in the $300 to $400 range. So I wasn't upcharged, obviously. So, all right, let's get to mine. First one, I pulled this card. Not a whole lot of value. Robert Kalaz is a Rockies prospect. I didn't open up much Bowman this year, but I really, really like this guy. I'm trying to potentially buy a few more of his cards. Except he's on the Rockies, and for the most part, Rocky prospects don't get a whole lot of love and hype, but he's a young kid, like 18, and he's absolutely crushing it so far in the minors. So again, it wasn't number or anything. One of these, what's it called? Like lunar glows, but I decided to send it in, and we did get a 10 at least. So not sure what I'll do with that one. Probably just keep it. It's probably not more than a $25 card there. And another PC card here is my boy Matt Shaw. Just bought this raw on eBay. It was nothing, $5, maybe even less than that. Just a refractor. I think he'll be up in the big leagues at some point this year. I want to get an autograph of him as well. He's a stud. He'll probably, it says shortstop, but I think he's going to take over to third base for the Cubs. And oh, we got a 10 there too, so we are starting off good again. My guys, my buddies didn't get a whole lot of 10s. PC card as well. The price was so good to send these in at whatever it was, $14 or $15. I'm from Chicago, Bulls fan, Julian Phillips. With all the trades, with DeMar gone, Caruso gone, he was our first round pick last year. Maybe he gets a little bit more time. Not a big deal here, but it cost me nothing. It was like $5 or $6 on eBay, so... Little auto. and we got a 9 on that one. So there's our first 9, Jillian Phillips. Here's a funny one. This is a bad time or bad timing on this one. Orelvis Martinez was leading the minor leagues, or at least top 3 in home runs, and having a really good year for Toronto. A ton of talk about him getting called up to the majors. And then all of a sudden, he got suspended for using some type of steroid or something in his body, and got caught, and he's suspended for like 60 or 80 games. So this card went from having a little bit of value to not a whole lot. So no matter what the grade is on this one, I'm just gonna hold it until he gets back. Hopefully he gets another chance, but it's out of 50 gold. Orelvis Martinez, Bowman Chrome Auto. And at least we did get a 10. It's a good looking card though, at least. Not the easiest to grade, 3 out of 50. So that one we'll just hold and wait for him. And this guy just got called up to the major leagues, actually. And he went to Cal Poly, which is where I went to college here in Central California. So I just wanted a couple of his autographs, kind of just for a PC. I do have one Bowman autograph of him, so that's cool. This was a Bowman Sterling out of 125. It wasn't a very expensive card, like 15 bucks. Again, he's in the majors now, so let's see if we can get another Lee 10. And we cannot, another 9 there. Bummer. All right. I think I just have one football, oh, two football cards, so probably should do the other one here first. We'll do this one. This is a Will Levis Airborne. What is that from? Rookies and Stars. It was numbered, obviously, out of 149. I just got this out of an auction. Didn't cost much. I think like 15 bucks shipping. I like Will Levis. It was numbered. I figured, why not? Looked good, so I sent it in for grading, and we got a 10. Let's go. Very nice. Will Levis. And then the last football card, this is for sure a PC. My friend Alvin, who was the guy that we talked about earlier, that had some cards in this submission. He was nice enough. He knows I'm from Chicago. I'm a Bears fan. He pulled this last year and decided to give it to me as a gift. It's a Genesis Roschon Johnson. He's going to be like the third string running back for the Bears next year since we got DeAndre Swift. But I do think he'll take over number 2. And I know the Bears like them, so you never know with injuries and stuff. And again, it's just pretty much a PC card, but it's a Genesis. Looked good. And we did get a 10. So, Mr. Alvin, that's an awesome gift. We got a 10 as well. Roschon Johnson, Genesis, Chicago Bears. So we're doing pretty good. All right, here's a Pods. This is a Mezzanine Prism from Select. Not a crazy card, probably not a ton of value. It's a blue prism, as you can see, but I live here in the Bay Area, so this will be an easy card for me to probably move. So I decided to send it in for grading, and right, we got a 10. Man, we're doing pretty good, actually. Probably just jinxed it. So 9's there. We got my PC cards here. Football, basketball. All right. Throw that there. This is a guy I am going a little bit nuts on, Cam Whitmore. Bought this one on eBay as well. It's a red cracked ice, just the concourse though. This again, probably borderline if I should have sent this card in at all, but the red's kind of a color match with his uniform a little bit, and I got a lot of Cam Whitmore coming. I already got a lot of Cam Whitmore graded. I just think he's pretty fun. I think he scores a lot of points. He's an exciting player, and I think the Rockets will be better next year, so hopefully I'm right. And we did get a 10 there, though. Red cracked ice. Good-looking card, Mr. Whitmore. And here he is again. And this is even better because this is a prism. It's definitely a little bit thicker right to left. And this grader seems to be a little bit on the tougher side, at least for my friends, but it looks pretty good. Besides that, it should be within the tolerance. Kind of a color match. Prism and... ooh, let's go. Man, we are doing well. We are doing well. All right, here we go. I pulled this card, Mezzanine out of 99, Jairus Walker. It's definitely, if you could see, a little bit thicker here than here. It's not too bad. Jairus Walker, not a ton of buzz about him, but it was like a purple cracked ice. It was just a good looking card. It's a rookie. So I figured, why not? Why not grade it? Even looks, you could tell this thicker here to there. So odds are we're going to get a PSA 9 here, but let's just see. And wow, 10. Jeez, I mean, I don't know. Maybe just my friends, maybe Alvin's cards were just a little beat up. I'm not sure why I'm getting a lot of 10s. This is good. All right, Brandon Miller, obviously we know him. He is the second best rookie to most people. Actually, I don't want to do that one yet. I had some other ones. I didn't think I mixed this up. Let's do these two first. Monopoly is obviously, it's a little bit less valuable than the Prism, so I want to do this one first. Good looking card. Maybe a touch thicker right to left, but pretty good here. What's this called? Free parking. Brandon Miller Prism Monopoly free parking. And we got a 9. So the streak is over on the 10s. All right. Still doing good though. And then here's another Monopoly, but this one is actually numbered out of 249. Excuse me, just bumped it here. And this is a brown. Brandon Miller, brown out of 249, a little thicker top to bottom. If that last one got a 9, this is probably going to get a 9, but let's see if we get lucky. And we did get the 9, so all good. All right, now let's go to this one. This is a regular Brandon Miller. This is a, obviously, pink ice. Bought this on eBay. Actually, I bought these two on eBay as well, so... this one looks better. Let's get the 10 train going, please. Ah, 3 nines in a row. I've had trouble with Brandon Miller. That sucks. And here's my last Brandon Miller, so hopefully I get one. This one I actually pulled. It is a premier level red cracked ice. Come on, Brandon, give me 110. All right, here we go. Got 110. Cool. All right, starting to get close to some of my bigger cards now. Expecting a 9 here for sure. Zion Williamson, as you can see, it's thicker on this left side than this right side. My friend Ron decided to buy some Prism multi-packs of this year, 2019. They were actually really cheap. He got them on a great deal. And I somehow pull this card, and I figured, why not? I got a grade. It looks really good here. Just a little bit off center on this side, but Ron pulled a silver, I believe, so it's even better. But I got a red, white, and blue Zion, which was crazy because I literally opened up so many packs of this in 2019, and I never got one Zion card. Literally not one. Not even a base, and yet I pulled a red, white, and blue, so... expecting a 9 here, but I think there's a chance. Obviously, I wouldn't have sent it in if I didn't think so. This would be a good one. Oh, let's go. That's sick. That is actually sick. It's sick just because I could imagine going... I could imagine getting this card from PSA in 2019 when this card was like probably $700, $800. It'd be how nervous I was. Wow, that's cool. I just figured with this side being so much thicker, you can tell, it's not that bad, but I thought this was going to get a 9. I'm going to keep that. It's cool. All right, here we go. Oh, yeah, I remember this one. So this one, I remember I pulled this card, and the reason why I'm showing this one first is because I just thought I was gonna get a 9. Look how much thicker this side is here than here. But it's a Victor, I mean, look at that. It's way thicker here than here. You guys can kind of tell. This is, I mean, pretty, this is gonna be a 9, might even be an 8. But it's a, it was my first big Wemby pull. It was from Select, it's a green, white, and purple. And I just think anything slabbed up in a Victor is probably, if you got any type of shot for a 10, you got to just do it. So again, hopefully a 9. Definitely won't be a 10. Okay, we did get a 9 at least. Okay, fair enough. And again, I'm just sending anything Victor. Not sure how much these just base concourse Victor Wembanyamas are going for. This one looked way better. Probably in the $40-$50 range if I were to guess. And there's our first 10 Wemby. Same exact card. These were all pulled, guys. All of these Wembys were pulled. I am not buying him on eBay. Too expensive. All right, we're 2 for 2 with the base. And now we got 1, 2, 3. I think we have 5 cards left. These are my 5 most valuable. And again, I wasn't upcharged for any of these. So here we go. All right, this isn't anything crazy here. Next one really isn't either. I pulled this Thunder Lane, but it is a prism. I don't know what it's a green. So we got a Wemby Select green Thunder Lane. Again, from Select. I did really well with Select and Wemby. And we pulled this, and let's see. And we got a 10. Thunder Lane green. Okay. I like it. Pulled this as well, but it's just a base. But obviously, I think these are going for around $100 in PSA 10 for just a base Wemby from Prism. So number 2. Nice. Very nice. Okay. And now my 3 biggest cards. So I don't know. Obviously, I want 10s, but I don't know what the number is. If you were to tell me I got 2 out of 3 10s, yeah, I'd be ecstatic. I'd be very happy. But I'm scared because I wasn't upcharged that I might get 0. A couple of these are not worth $500. Probably this one. Yeah, this is just a... this is just the concourse, but it is the blue prism. So this is not a $500 card, but looks good. Pull this out of a mega box. And we got a 10. Okay. Very good. Now my 2 big ones. Victor Wembanyama. This is the mezzanine, and it is a prism. Looks pretty good here from the back. Yeah, it looks really good, guys. It is a blue cracked ice mezzanine. I don't know what the value of this card is. Probably not $500, but obviously would be a good one and a 10. 2 cards left, guys. These are my 2 biggest ones. Wish me luck. And come on, baby. Let's go. Okay. Well, we got 2 out of 3. That's all I asked for, right? So I'm happy. I could have gotten over 3. So here it is, the last card, guys. This was one of my biggest pulls in my life, and definitely my biggest pull this year. It looks so good. I mean, is it perfect? No, it is a tiny bit thicker on this right side compared to the left. And but here, guys, look at that. It just looks absolutely perfect everywhere. The problem is this one I did look up. This is a $1,000 card. So how they would not upcharge me if this wasn't a 10, I don't know. But let's see if this is a 9. I'm going to crack it and resend it. But let's see if we can somehow finish with a bang and see if I got lucky. Okay, does it say silver? It does say silver, so it's not like they didn't know it wasn't. Last card, guys. Thanks for joining me. It was a long video. Victor Silver PSA 10. I want to keep one nice Victor card. And just in case he ends up being the guy. And this is probably the one I'm going to keep if it's a 10. Everything else I'm going to sell. So here we go, guys. Thanks for joining me, and here we go. Come on. Oh, my God. It's a 10. How was I not upcharged? How was I not upcharged? Wow. Wow. How was I not upcharged? Wow. That's unbelievable. Oh, this is so fun. God, this grading cards could be, it's such a rush. It could be, but it also could be, when it goes the other way, guys, it's so brutal. But man, for my friends to get literally 7 PSA 10s out of like 23 cards, and I got like 80% PSA 10s, and even Johnny got a PSA 10. I'm kind of shaking a little bit. So, well, I was not expecting these final three cards to get 10s. It's nothing crazy. I'm not going to be able to retire or anything like that, but three really nice Wemby cards, especially this one. I mean, this is cool. Probably not a whole lot of those in the world. Wow. And even the base got a 10. That's nuts. I can't believe I wasn't upcharged. I don't know. I got lucky. All right. Well, that's it for the day, guys. That was awesome. That definitely my biggest PSA reveal of the year so far. I do have a couple of more at PSA now, but they just started the grading special, our grading process, excuse me. So we're probably a month away before I get those. And then probably in the next day, I'm going to send in some football cards. There's a $15.99 football special. So I'll get those to PSA. And yeah, that's it. So thanks for joining me, man. Appreciate the love of the channel. Please subscribe if you haven't. We're doing a video every day, and this was just craziness. We got a 10 on the Victor Wembanyama silver. That's awesome. Have a great day, guys. I'll tell you what, I'm having a great day, and we'll see you on a video tomorrow. Peace.